Hello and welcome to class. I want to believe that you've been having a nice time taking our online classes. Today we shall be discussing a very important topic. And what is that topic? ICT. ICT stands for Information and Communication Technology. It is the convergence of telecommunication and computer technology. An ICT system is a setup consisting of hardwares, softwares and communication technologies such as the internet. ICT systems are used in almost every field you can think about. Talk about medicine, talk about education like we're having now, talk about communication, talk about business and management. It finds application in all these fields. Types of ICT or communication systems. We have broadcasting system, telecommunication, data network, information system, and satellite communication. Let's look at these types of ICT in detail. We start from broadcasting. What is broadcasting? This is the distribution of audio and video content to a dispersed audience via telecommunication to the communication media. We have different methods of broadcasting. These methods include telephone broadcasting, radio broadcasting, television broadcasting, cable radio, webcasting, satellite television systems. When we say telecommunication, we are talking about the transmission of messages over significant distance using communication technologies such as fiber optic, microwave, and satellite. When we say fiber optic, we are talking about a medium that allows you to transmit messages in form of light through a medium. Then we say microwave. When we say microwave, we are not just talking about the microwave that you use for cooking at home. No, we are talking about the technology surrounding that microwave. Then we have satellite system, ETC. Types of telecommunication system. We have the circuit switch telephone network. A circuit switch telephone network is simply your analog telephone system where a user can send message from one end and it goes to another user at the other end. It's simply a one-end-to-one-end communication. Then we have packet switch network system. We'll say packet switch network system is more of the modern way of transmitting information where your messages are broken down into different packets and then transmitted through a telephone network. Then we have the public switch telephone network. A public switch telephone network is an aggregate of different circuit switch telephone network that comes together and is used for transmission of messages over very large distances. It could be controlled by a government, it could be controlled by large organizations. Then we have radio and television telecommunication system, and then we have optical telecommunication system. Now let's move and talk about data network. What is data network? This is the communication network that is devoted to carrying computer signals. The key word there is computer signals or computer information as opposed to voice and video. It consists of numbers of nodes or stations connected by various communication channels. Types of data network. We have the personal area network, PAN. Also, personal area network. It is a network of, let's say, just one person, consisting of maybe his laptop, his phone, a Bluetooth headset, and the like. And it spans over just few centimeters. Then we have the local area network. When we say local area network, it's a network that is made up of different personal network put together. That is, it has more systems or more hardware, and then it covers larger distance than the personal area network. A typical example is the network that you have in UPSS computer laboratory. Then we have the metropolitan area network. A metropolitan area network is a network that is made up of different local area network put together. It cuts across a metropolis or a city. Then we have the wide area network. A wide area network is a network that is made up of different metropolitan area network. A wide area network covers larger distance than the metropolitan area network, and it could span across a country or a continent, say Africa, for example. Then we have the internet. The internet is an aggregate of different wide area network coming together. As a matter of fact, the internet is a network that cuts across the globe. What that means is somebody in Afghanistan, for example, can share messages to somebody in Mars, planet Mars. Yes, of course. That is what the internet is made up of. We have the information system. When we say information system, we're talking about an aggregated set of components used to collect, create, distribute useful data, typically in an organization setting. An information system consists of hardwares, softwares, telecommunication technology procedures, and people who man these devices. The types of information system include the executive support system, ESS. We have the management information system. We have decision support system. We have knowledge management system. And then we have transaction processing system, as well as the automated system, OAS. When we say satellite communication, this is the use of satellite technology for communication. Services provided by satellite communication are voice, video calling, internet, television, and even radio broadcasting. How does the satellite communication work? It is a bit simple. We have a transmitter on Earth that transmits the signal to the satellite in space. And that satellite in space rebroadcasts that signal back to Earth, where different receivers on Earth will pick the signal, and that signal will be transmitted, or will have a transmitter on Earth that transmits the signal to a satellite that is located in space. That satellite in space rebroadcasts the signal back to Earth, where we have different satellite signal receivers or dishes on Earth that picks up the signal that has been rebroadcast from the satellite in space and then converts that signal into either audio or video, depending on the message that is encoded in the signal. Services provided by satellite communication are voice and video calling, the internet, we have televisions and radio broadcasting. ICT gadgets. When we say ICT gadget, this is something that you and I are familiar with. It is something that we use every day. These gadgets include the internet connected devices, mobile devices supported by wireless and even wired technology. They include your computer, the automated teller machine, the point of sale terminals, satellites, mobile phones, telephones, television, radio, fax machines, and the likes. With that, we've come to the end of another interesting class. Please, I would like you to attempt the assignments that I have dropped at the end of this class. I want to use this opportunity to appreciate those of you who have been faithful in doing your assignments and asking questions. I believe that these classes that you are taking has made you better oriented or inclined when it comes to computer science. Thank you very much for being a part of this class. See you in my next class.